still on my local recording, just in case I need to upload those personally for some reason.
Oh, yeah, okay. Makes sense.
The only thing that sucks about doing that is that it takes up a lot of space after so long.
Yeah, as Chaos is saying, light swans were meta through this era, so, like, it does make sense.
This is always a good song to start up when I do the second stream. Always like this one. Alright, so now I enter. That comes back to you.
Yep, and it does go to a main monster zone. It does not go back to the extra one, so... Which, funnily enough, if I had a full main thing here, then it would just go to graveyard instead. Okay, let's see. So, standby main. You know what? I think I'm probably okay with that. Or am I? Because you wouldn't have. Yeah, no, I think I'm okay with that. I'm gonna normal summon Spirit Reaper.
Yeah.
So yeah, battle phase. We're gonna have these two crash each other.
Yep.
To grave, and then so we will hit with the Spirit Reaper first. Yeah.
Yeah, let's do the 300 here.
And then that rips the card out of the hand, and yeah, as you say, taking the 15. Ooh, Janice. Okay, not too bad. Go ahead. I might get punished for it, but we'll see.
Not yet.
Ooh, wow. It's even something I can still try and rip out of the hand as well. Okay. Alright, let's normal summon that Corbot Hedgehog that you knew of.
Yeah, Hedgehog. Where's that damn fourth Hedgehog?
Well, it's not a Hedgehog, but it is that damn fourth Chaos Dragon that's gonna come out here as well. So... That's... pretty good.
Is that game 3042, 45... Not it yet, but it will be if you guys make it back too.
Yeah. Alright.
Man, the jaws are rough.
I knew I had it, but... Yeah, it's tough. I don't know. This is a very weird experimental deck right now, but we'll see. You know, I kind of want to just do that. Whether or not that's actually a good idea is yet to be seen, but I kind of want to just do that. I sure did, Chaos. I sure did. He's saying someone got gold pulls. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Let's just start with Jayne. Jayne is still good, so there's still reason to use her.
Yep.
How afraid am I of Heavy Storm? Probably afraid enough. End phase will mill too. I mean, that's actually probably better for me, to be honest. Like, if I draw traps, then they're nice, but it's like, if I draw those traps just now, it's like, maybe I don't have enough monsters or something.
Yeah.
I might actually get to a monster in the deck now or something. Yeah, that should be better. You missed a decent bit. We're in the second of the synchro sets here, Misty, so you missed a decent bit.
Well, how scared were you about Heavy Storm? You were right to be scared.
Okay, it is actually Torrential Tribute, so that's a pretty good one to hit.
That is still a pretty good one, because now we can Special Summon.
Here it comes, yep.
And guess what? Normal Summon.
Oh my god, over every time! Oh jeez, yep. Dang, dude, that's like glued to your hand here, it's crazy.
I mean, it's a pretty good draw. Alright, so...
How many Resonator did you get, then?
I put in 3, so I have 3.
You actually got a full playset, dude. I got 0 of them. That's ridiculous.
That's funny. Alright, well, after that, now...
Yep.
What did you draw? Nothing? Okay.
Oh, this is a blowout. Oh my god.
Send that to Brave. Alright. When it attacks, so... Cyber Dragon is good to attack.
Yeah, it is. I'm just gonna take the 28 direct here because I know you're gonna hit the Stardust as well, so...
I mean, I still wanna make it official.
Yeah, hell no, I'll do it anyway. That's not what I'm just trying to expedite the process of it.
Alright, set one card and turn.
Woof.
Now,
okay.
Undraw.
Yep. Oh, this is such a good dodge shit too. Oh my god. Ow.
Ooh.
This is such a good dodge shoot.
Okay, so you have just the light in your graveyard, so you can't activate that. So, yes, Cyber Dragon goes back.
Damn. Yeah, that's probably gonna do it, but obviously it's not quite over just yet, but it might as well be. Because I don't actually think... No, I don't think there's a... I mean, I might as well set and pass and see. I don't think there's any one card that I could draw here that would actually make a difference, but yeah, I just got hosed out by the god draw at the start here.
I'm sorry, speaking of god draws.
Yeah, alright. Yeah, you can't do anything about that. That's the obvious perfect five, six card to start with. Really.
I mean, that's fine. That was, okay, so yeah, that was a pretty intense draw there, my gosh.
It is what it is. There's like actually nothing you can really do about that, but hey, it's fine. Yeah, I mean, as I say, the God Draw to get it out would have been like Spirit Reaper, but then Change of Heart Top Deck is like, yep, it's fine. And it's not like super upsetting or anything, really. It's just like, yeah, what are you expected to do about that? Like,
yeah.
There's just nothing that could actually have helped there. Excuse you.
Excuse
Jesus
me.
Hell, dude.
Yeah, I guess breakfast was a bit more impactful than I thought it would.
Let's try that.
Good time for Flandre Sting to be coming up, by the way.
Sorry?
It's a good time for Flandre Sting to be popping up here.
Yeah. Alright, let's do that. Go ahead.
Good old T-Pose. Alright. Alright, one normal summon.
Yep.
Garuth. Alright.
Yeah, to not get killed, draw better cards. That's the advice.
really, yeah. I am like 98% sure that's Witch, but I'm gonna attack anyway.
You are 2% correct. Yep, it is Witch, so...
2% correct, better than 1%. The best kind of correct.
Yeah.
No, wait, how'd it go? Oh, Mr. Conrad, you are technically correct. The best kind of correct.
hang on, let me see. Nah, I'm gonna get Rose. Yeah, I'm gonna take Rose.
Pretty good target for that. Alright.
That's pretty good, yeah.
Yep. Yes, Lion Sworn Paladin. Hey, how you doing? Alright, main phase 2. Yeah, I'm gonna set 1 and 2.
Alrighty then. Anything on draw?
Nope.
Okay. I'm not gonna get dust shooted this time, that's fine.
Not this time.
Alright, let's try my Jane then, I suppose.
Alright.
Be pretty reasonable.
Yeah.
Battle phase, we'll try and attack.
Yeah, that's fine. So that's 2100, okay. So that's 250.
250. End phase, we'll mill the two. Call is pretty good. Cyber Dragon. Alright. Could be worse. Yeah, right. It's a light swarm that doesn't immediately mill.
Not immediately, yeah. Alright, well, let's face face down.
Chain threatening war. No attacking for you this turn. This is why I'm playing it, to be honest, because it can change the stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good one. Alright, I'll set the one and pass.
Alrighty. Okay, let's just try and get in then, I guess. Normal summon Rose?
Yeah.
Battle phase, we will attack with Jane. Okay, and then Rose will do... hopefully.
Yeah, I'm gonna activate.
Okay, compulse the Rose?
Yeah, compulse the Rose.
Yeah, okay, so back to hand, right? It's fine. Main 2, we will set 1. End phase, mill 2. Lots of good cards going in. There's the once again, Black Corner Heavy getting milled.
Here we go again.
No, after activated, it just gets milled.
Just gets milled, sadly. Yep.
Yo, Flux, good evening.
Alright. Well, let's normal summon.
Yep.
It's fine. Alright. Battle phase?
Going into your battle phase, I'm gonna threaten Will.
Again!
Yep.
Fine, I'll end turn on that.
Alright. Let's see. Alright, let's try this again then, shall we? We'll summon Rose.
Yep.
Battle phase, we will attack with Jane. Right.
On that battle.
Ah, second compulse. Rip. Okay.
Compulse your Jane then.
Well, so here's the thing then. It's a good job I didn't summon Stardust Dragon, because that would have been even worse. Okay. We're gonna just set one and.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't go for the Synchro Summon too early, because those compulses would have made it really annoying. Just a bunch of traps in my grave at the moment.
And two of them are threatening wards, making me even more annoying. Alright, well, we can normal summon.
Oh boy, yep, yeah, okay. That's fair. You got the summon out.
I do have it, yeah. I'm not gonna synchro summon this time though.
I think you'll do a bit more damage if you don't do it first, huh?
Yep. So battle phase. Garoth will attack first.
Yep, and I will take the 250. And she goes.
Then Dark Resonator will try to attack.
Directly. I am going to call of the Haunted and bring back the Rose.
Back again. All right.
She will have her revenge, dang it.
all right. Well, main phase 2. I guess it's a good thing then. So now I can synchro.
Yep. So you've already got the hang of this. That's all you need to do for synchro summoning. There you go. Yep, yeah. Life transfer.
Just whenever I feel like, I guess.
Yeah, pretty much.
Alright. So, main phase 2 then, I'll... set... and end turn.
Okay. My draw fine, yeah?
Yep.
Alright, yeah, let's normal summon Jane.
Again, yep.
Yeah, and we will synchro these two off for Stardust. Where is he? There he is.
Yep.
Battle phase, Stardust hits. At 100 makes all the difference in this thing, doesn't it?
I mean, in a game like this, it really does. It really does. Oh, I have to set one and pass.
Okay. Alright, which one do I fear more? Because I'm gonna have Breaker.
Yep.
Breaker's just gonna use its effect, I'm gonna take out the middle one. giant trap hole. Okay. That's an interesting one. Alright, it's good enough for me. Breaker
yep,
is an attack.
4100.
Yeah. Go ahead. Yeah, giant trap hole is an interesting card for sure.
Set one and pass.
Ooh, okay. So annoyingly, because Breaker's at 16, can't actually win on board without all the attacks going through. So I guess I'll normal summon Spirit Reaper then.
Alright.
Just in case, because if my attacks don't all go through, I can at least rip the card out of the hat. So yeah. We'll go for that first. Okay. Ooh, the dragon. Alright, and then Breaker? And game?
Almost.
Okay, so I am going to attribute this then to negate the effect, but I don't get the attack off, obviously. I figured Mirror Force was going to be down there, but it's like, yeah, I deem that. Alright, main two, we will set one. End phase, Stardust comes back by its own effect, because I didn't get negated, so it special summons itself again.
Yeah.
And you are good to go.
Alright. Alright, I guess I'm gonna have to do it this way. Normal summon.
Yep, okay. I'm trying to figure out where this is going at this point. Yeah, if it wasn't for the Spirit Reaper, you'd have a card in hand to get Dragon it back with here, so...
Yeah.
Fortunate on my end.
Alright, what would be the odds of that being a thing?
Oh, Brownie.
Okay, battle phase. Let's attack the Spirit Reaper.
Yeah, I will take the 7 as soon as my Stardust decides it's gonna not mouse over the thing there.
Hang on, sorry, I need to ask this.
That's okay.
Alright. I guess I'll have to end phase and mill free.
Yeah. Oh, Monster Reborn going as well.
That's a tough one. All right.
Yeah. Okay. Probably not worth overextending here, is it? That said, if that is something that can block an attack, I mean, what, you've gone through a lot now, right? Two Compulse and the Mirror Force, I don't think you play much else that stops attacks. So, I guess I will just not overextend here, we'll try and hit in.
Well, let's see if this works.
Oh.
Pay down some life points, and I can and I can banish Mirror Force.
Huh. Can I, okay, I know there's a bunch of you in chat saying that, can I Stardust that? Because the effect is now being treated as Mirror Forcing. Since this card's effect is now destroy all attack position monsters on my field, right? Because I actually don't know how this works. And it seems like the two main buffs in here don't know either. Because obviously if I can Stardust this, it's game over because I have just enough attack on board. But I actually don't know if I can.
I mean, the thing says it becomes that of targets of that target's activated effect. Which the target effect is destroy all your opponent's attack position monsters.
Yeah. So you would think, but I'm actually I wouldn't know. This is the thing of just not having played in the era and stuff, right? It depends on the timing the effect changes, I think. Yeah, that's what I'm worried about. Okay, let me Google some stuff as well then. Let's see, Stardust Dragon versus Trap of Darkness. Let's see if that does anything.
Amazing how we keep trying to find these little nitbits of information. We're like, okay, we need to know what this does.
Yeah. Okay, that is not yielding me anything. That's just yielding versus Light and Darkness Dragon, which is not what I'm interested in right now. Not getting anything, but finding something interesting. Stardust can negate Tarantula and Deus Coming. Yeah. It can't negate Dice Rolls, because the Dice Rolls are not guaranteed to be destroying something, but this is, so...
Nothing on Yu-Gi-Oh! Wiki. Well...
Yeah, that's the thing, isn't it? It's like...
We keep finding these weird loophole kind of, like, situations.
Uh-huh. Okay, so it's like...
It's hilarious, actually.
Pay 1,000, then target one normal trap in your graveyard, except Trap of Darkness. That is the cost.
Yes.
So then this card's effect becomes the... Oh, this is super weird. I have no idea. See, I don't. It's not because I win off of it. I want to say it does, but I don't.
I mean,
that's just because it would intuitively make sense to me that it would.
Yeah.
But we can't call a judge because this is a private game. Actually, funny fact about that, somebody just commented in one of the most recent ones going, why is Cold Judge grayed out? It's probably because it's a private game. Yeah, I mean, I want to say that it would just because it intuitively does make sense. Your card's effect is now Mirror Forces, but it really does depend on the timing of it.
Yeah.
Okay, so the problem with solving card tests for this, your life points of 3,000 or less is the activation condition. Pay 1,000 life points, then target one normal trap in your graveyard except Trap of Darkness. That is the cost. And then the effect is this card's effect becomes that target's activated effect. So it actually might not, because it's on effect resolution is when it changes its effect, right? Yeah, that actually would make more sense. So I think actually, looking at it, I don't think it does.
we may have to start hosting public games if we're going to do keep running into this and be like, all right, we need a judge.
I don't know if that would necessarily
judge, man, help me out here. Help me alone. I must win my first card game on my motorcycle.
Yeah. Synchro, what? Yo, Black Hook? That's White Knot is your skinny head. Yo, how's it doing?
Black Hook.
How's it going?
I haven't seen him in a while.
Yeah.
Still doing the arts on DeviantArts. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not seeing anything on Trapadonna's here of it. Okay, maybe it's because this might make it a bit more interesting with the stuff here, but I'm actually kind of on the boat of saying I kind of want to say it doesn't work.
Okay, the ruling says it can't activate in damage step.
Right, that's for Trapadonna's as well, though. You're not activating this in the damage step.
No.
Because you're not using something that changes attack defense here. Which one of us is using Dragon Maids? We're not anywhere near that right now, dude.
I mean,
this is a draft theory.
I mean, I had dragons. I could probably still use dragons, but that depends on what I would draw next time or later.
Nah, he's asking about Dragon Maid, which is an archetype way later on.
Oh, Dragon Maid? No, I don't like Dragon Maid. Dragon Maid to only teach me sweeping from Genes of Sephiroth, and that's it.
There you go. That's the one. Yeah, this is in the battle step, so if it was going to be able to... I'm actually erring on the side of saying no based on the way the card text is here. Yeah, I mean, if I had... No, actually, that wouldn't work anyway, Misty, because the cost is to banish the card. It's like you're saying, shame I don't have DD Crow for an easy solution. No, because the cost of activating this card is to pay 1,000 life points and banish the trap. The trap is already gone. I can't chain DD Crow to this. I'm erring on the side of saying no, like it actually will go through. And the reason I'm sort of thinking that is because of the way the cost is set up here. It's like the effect only happens on resolution. It is currently not the effect of Mirror Force until it resolves.
Hmm. Which that effect becomes its own thing afterwards.
Yeah, at which point the effect will change, but I think that's on resolving, I can't react to it at that point. It's like remember I mentioned with like Raikou and stuff of the whole like choosing targets.
Yeah,
we're using Dolan Book, dude. I'm actually gonna say that's the way forward. So I'm gonna Book of Moon my Stardust in order to save that thing.
All right,
because I'm going on the assumption, I know we've been at this for a while now a bit, I'm going on the assumption that it actually doesn't let me destroy it because of the way the effect changes here. And so as a result, yeah, I'm going to do that, and then the other two get destroyed. Partly because I want this game to like move on as well, but...
Yeah, I mean, we have all day if you really wanted to.
We do, but there's also kind of whatever. Right, so I'm going to play Graceful. I could have just gone for it straight away, but I wanted to see first. Okay, let's send you. And I suppose. You to the graveyard here.
This is when you get Chaos Emperor Dragon again.
I mean, this is what I was hoping for, I'll be honest. It's not Chaos Emperor, but I am going to take Brain Control.
Ooh.
Yeah, I have one copy of this, so. And I haven't summoned this turn at all because I went straight for game. So I'm going to normal summon the crabs. And we're going to synchro these two off to get the six out.
It's a 2 and a 5, though.
Oh, it is a 5, isn't it? Oh, for fuck's sake. Never mind. Put it back on your field then. I'm stoops. I thought it was a level 4 and not a level 3.
Nope.
I'm a stoop. What the hell is my crab? Where the hell's Krebon's got? Oh, you've already got Krebs out of my grave or something? No, it's there. Where the hell?
It's right there in the top left.
I can't see. Oh, top left. Okay, I was like, I can't see it in my deck. Oh, graveyard there. Yeah, I'm stoops. Okay, whatever. Yeah, you can dingy it back. I thought it was 4. I don't know why. I've been looking at it the whole time,
Oh, wait a minute. Would you build your top three since it's on your end phase? Since you can't control Lumina?
Oh my god, I don't know! Because I don't know when the effects change that way. It's like, do I get to choose which effect goes? Because they're both like mandatory things,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, because take control until the end phase, but this thing says during your end phase.
Well, if it's until the end phase, then by end phase start, you would have it back, right?
I guess. Yeah, I guess that would make sense.
He's saying, let me check, I think this is turn player sets order, at which point, yeah, I would be giving it back to you before I mill.
Which I would mean the light swarms are a bit more annoying if your opponent uses them, because then you can, like, control them and not have to use the cost.
Yeah.
The timing of brain control is at start, so no, he wouldn't.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. It's like, because the way it says until the end phase, it's like, yeah, okay.
Alright, that makes...
Sorry for all the dumb all right, stuff here.
That makes sense.
Man, if only I had Magical Android from the previous set, that would have been the right thing.
That would have been...
Damn it, I keep...
Okay. Now, here's an interesting thing. I need to make a really stern decision with this.
Ah, you gotta make like a soul read for this at the moment. Oh dear god. You got this out of that retro pack, didn't you?
Yep.
Is there a common in there?
It's a rare, I think. I'll take a look at it. But yeah, it's a pretty good card, actually. Alright, now, again, I actually have to think of some cards here.
I think I know what can happen over here as well.
Oh, this is going to be a tough decision here. Alright. Oh, decisions.
I mean, I will admit, this does make the game a lot more interesting. I'm seeing the... Painful Choice is such a tough one to run in Light Swan like this,
yeah.
But yeah, because you're already milling anyway, but it's totally understandable why.
Right, so I'm going to take Ace of Cyber Dragon.
Yeah, there you go, Black Hook. Loser gets their legs chopped off by a buzzsaw, right? But don't worry, it's just an imaginary buzzsaw. It just sends you to the purple realm.
I don't think it'll work that way. No. I'll decide. I'll choose Light Sworn Saber. Sabri.
That will actually work the way you're thinking it will, by the way. If I send that to the graveyard, it will actually get quick.
So that's a funny thing. Oh, again, the decisions here. Let's do another Cyber Dragon.
Okay.
Again, this is getting some tough decisions here. Decisions. Let's banish that one.
I wanted to get back into the physical game, so I got the Endymion construction deck, and then I read the Endymion's effects. That was your first mistake.
That was your first mistake. Haha. And oh, fuck. I guess I'll do you. So,
okay.
aside from Ferris Force, it's two Cyber Dragons, Light Sworn Saber, Jayne, and Janice.
The only correct choice is the Saber, to be honest, because otherwise you're going to get that for free anyway. So, yeah, you're going to have to just send the others out.
Very interesting card to draw here, definitely.
Mmm.
You think? I don't know. I don't think he would have allowed me to have it. I really don't think he would have. Oh well, alright, well we'll activate it here.
Okay.
So now she has 700 attack. Actually no, that should have been me resummoning a paladin or something.
Do you want to resummon it? Because this, it might as well. I'm okay with you taking it back to this one, because honestly, that's what I was expecting you to do in the first place.
Yeah, I better do that.
Alright, because I think otherwise this game is automatically over, because Stardust is bigger than her, you know, like, defense is 2k, yeah. So...
And regardless who I bring out,
oh, I know that Mimicry card, Blacker. That's it. That's a really nice one.
That one, or do I want? Sorry, this is like really tough decision here. I don't think I'm going to wait out of it anyway.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Okay, so
I'd give you my input, but that's not really not really appropriate, is it?
I mean, Brownie's given his input in the chat a lot here. Like, there's one card he's suggesting I should have used, but nah.
Oh, you can't even do what I wanted to do. Well, shit, okay.
Did it have to be summoned in defense mode? No, it's just you can target one level 4 Light Sworn monster, special summon a target. So it's either attack or defense mode.
Alright, first off, I didn't realize this was level 4 or lower. That's unfortunate, yeah. Stipulation here that messes up, because obviously you take the dragon otherwise.
Oh.
I think there's only really one appropriate option.
Yeah,
here,
there is
honest.
Actually. Now I'm actually thinking about it. Okay. Now I know.
Yeah. The only appropriate option is Jayne, because she's the only one who can get over Stardust.
Yeah. Alright.
Which I couldn't flip summon because it declared an attack that turn, so yeah.
Alright. Main phase 2, set defense mode.
Yep.
End phase, mill 2 and 3.
Yeah. Oh.
Damn.
Negotiating, yeah. Ha! Black Hook, burn the witch! I don't even need it, but I'm going to do it anyway because it's the easiest way for it. He literally just said in my chat, use Regeki. And I fucking top deck Regeki. Literally burn the witch.
Wow.
Literally burn the witch. The reason I didn't need it is because I had Tribe in hand. So any summon that I would have pulled, I would have just used Tribe twice.
That's rough.
Yeah, that was unfortunate. I don't know what the right play with it there was. I'm not sure if the... Oh, you had Upstart in deck. That's cool. I'm not sure if there were five cards that you could have taken that would have actually let you...
Like, maybe come back. See, Brownie was suggesting there. Change of Heart in one of the cards for Painful Choice, but like, no, you wouldn't have let me have that in the first place. I know that much.
Your Painful was what? It was the
it
Saber,
was two
the Double
Dragons, Saber,
the Double Dragon.
Lumina, and...
It's a Janus, yeah. Right? Yeah, so, I mean, you would have had to have not given me Saber as an option to do anything, because Saber is the only correct play out of everything there, really, because otherwise you just get it for free regardless, and it's a pain in the ass, right? Yeah, there's no way that I would have let you have anything but Janus in that situation, I don't think. Although, I guess I wouldn't have been able to out it without flipping it first, but... Still, if you'd have not been able to kill the Crabons... I was going to be able to synchro because I had the level 4 in hand. I was going to be able to synchro into that. Which I actually pulled 3 copies of because of course. I did. It's a rare, so like it's not as bad. I didn't get the life transfer, so that's the unfortunate one with it there. But yeah, so I got the 3 copies of that. That's what I wanted to synchro into, and apparently I just can't count. I didn't actually... It's not even that. I didn't realize that Lumina was a level 3 when I was going through my plays there. I was like, alright, I can just steal it and, like, sync it off then. But no, it's 3, not 4. So, that was a whoops. Yeah, so that was obviously dumb on my end. But, yeah, I don't think there was really... Even if I didn't get Regeki off the top, I don't think there was a set of cards you could have picked up there. Like, what would have been... Yeah, because even... You would have had to have
after,
probably
like,
gone absolutely all
yeah,
in.
I mean, that's my only choice there. Because, what, Judgment Dragon, then it would have been... Not Mirror Force. It would have been Dark Resonator next. Which, that wouldn't have been enough for anything I had.
So you probably would have had to have tried to do, like, Call of the Haunted, Snatch Steal, Pot of Greed, Mirror Force, Change of Heart. Something like that. And forced me to try and take one, like, really disgusting option. And even then, I think I would have probably still been fine actually giving you Change of Heart in that situation. Because what are you going to do? Are you going to Change your heart my Stardust and then I just still negate the attack with Krebs?
Like, change your heart a monster. Yeah, go ahead. Like, I'm going to get it back next turn. You're going to lose anyway. Like, that's why I didn't want Change of Heart. Or the only thing I could have... I mean, Snatch Steal would have been an option, but Snatch Steal was already in the graveyard at the time, I think. No, it wasn't. No,
it got milled from Jane. So I'm looking at everything from like Janus and below is what was in the grave already. I think because Janus was there anyway. Janus Saber, so everything below the Painful Choice, like the 2 Cyber Dragons were in deck. So yeah, no, I think it would have needed to have been something as ridiculous as that. Because, like, Call of the Haunted, you had Dragonif that you could have gotten, which was bigger than anything I had at the time. Snatch Steal, obviously, would... Actually, Snatch Steal... Do you have a level 5 Synchro?
No. Not in my deck,
Snatch Steal
no.
wouldn't even done it. Yeah, so that wouldn't have done it.
I mean, I probably have one in my... in my collection, but I need to have it checked that.
Mirror Force was away, so that couldn't have done it. You did still have Shield Warrior in Grave, so you could have blocked Destruction for one monster. But I don't think that would have made... Now, Honest would have had to have been something you'd have picked out. Because you would have needed to have been able to get over Stardust with that.
Well, you wouldn't have let me have Honest. I know you would not let me have it. Like, okay, out of all the cards I have in my deck, I was thinking, what cards would you let me have versus would you not let me have? I probably should have thought of, okay, 5 cards you wouldn't let me have. Let's try that.
Yeah, the point is with a painful in that situation, you need to find the five cards that no matter which one I take, one of them is going to get you back into the game. So maybe even Dark Resonators, because you have a 60 you could sink into, right?
Six? Do you? No, I don't think so.
No,
I think the only synchro I pulled from the Crossroads was Psychic Life Transfer.
Right, okay. Yo, Sale, thanks for the raid. Okay, so yeah, that wouldn't have been on the table either.
I don't think there was a way out of it. I mean, I wanted to try something, but you know, that was a tough one.
I very much appreciate the hustle of it, but yeah, I can't personally see a way out of it, but that doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It's just I don't know.
I didn't know either, but I was trying to think so hard. Like, okay, what possible thing could I do here? Like, what possible things would I be able to get here?
So I think something that we brought up in our chat there, I think the biggest mistake was not saving one of the compulses for when I synchroed into Stardust was probably the biggest problem there. Because it's like, using them to stop some damage beforehand was good, but then it only delayed the inevitable.
Well, I didn't know if you were going to get a tuner or not. That's the only thing about it. You weren't summoning your tuner mods. It's like, okay, what are the odds of him not having his tuner?
I was summoning...
You were summoning your
I was
Rose.
Summoning Rose every turn. So, yeah, she was coming out every turn, so there's my tuna.
Now, see, I can't claim to be the strongest player here, because I don't think these things through. In the end, if I do think these through, I overthink it and think of something else. This is what happened with the last duel of the third duel. It's like, I probably should use Mirror Force earlier instead of him waiting for him to Mystical Space Typhoon it. So, you know, I just can't think that through, I guess. Whatever.
That's understandable. I'm not trying to, like, you know, say, oh yeah, this way is the only right way for it or whatnot, because no, it's not necessarily. It's just, this was what we kind of came up with as we were going through. It's like, okay, you've used your compulses on the non-synchro monster so that I am eventually going to get it through, and it's eventually going to stick now that you've used your resources.
Trap of Darkness to use Compulse to send back your Synchro Monster. But even then, I wouldn't have been able to stop anything else.
Yeah, you wouldn't have been able to survive at that point. You needed to take Mirror Force off of that. Yeah. Alright, so... That was tough, and I totally understand the sort of thing with that. I don't know what do I want to do first here? I guess I can go over some of the experiments in this deck. The Quillbot Hedgehog I wanted to try and see, because it can special summon itself with the tuners out, right? And it gets a bit easier to get into stuff like Stardust and whatnot if I could summon another level 2 monster out as well. Wanted to make it work, it didn't show up really until it was too late, so it's kind of whatever. Some stuff I didn't show in here, I have Majestic Mech Ochre in my side deck. Like, it's a level 6, the level 6 one you can normal summon without tribute. Goes to the grave at the end of the turn. I found out that you can actually use that with Light Imprisoning Mirror, and because it's an activated effect that sends it to graveyard, and it's a light monster, so the mirror would actually stop it from working, and it wouldn't send itself to the graveyard so long as mirror is in play. So that was going to be fun, because that's a level 6. I could use that with Krebons to go in Stardust. Instant Fusion was picked up as one of the reasons why I wanted the stuff like the Darkfire Dragon, because I need a level 4. To go in of that. So I can instant fusion at a level 4, or if I needed a lower level 1 because of other tuners I had, I've got level 3 and 5 in here as well. I can instant fusion into one of these and then use that with a tuner for a synchro play, is the idea behind that. So I was experimenting with a lot of the different synchro shenanigans here, and then since I had the monsters for it. Because the other one I picked up, you got the Ghost Red Stardust Dragon. Mine is not as valuable, but I picked that one up. So only $199 or something.
Only $199, but there it is.
So, yeah, I picked a signature card in the setup. I also picked up this one, but I can't summon it because I don't have place credit. But it looks kind of cool. The other one that I got, which I didn't put in the deck at the moment, if we had more time, I would have tried to maybe look and see if I've got enough for a plant deck. Because I got the Queen of Roses thing, or whatever it is as well. The level 6 one, it's a light plant. It needs a tuner and a non-tuner plant monster. And if you want to, if either player wants to summon a non-plant monster, it costs them 1,000 life points, like, every time. And I was like, that's kind of cool. It's 2,200 too. So like, that's kind of cool. There's a decent stun effect on it, but I didn't have time to try and build a plant deck off of this right now. It's something that I wouldn't mind trying to do because I have a few of the pieces for it. But like two Lone Fire Blossom, one Giga Plant, I can maybe make up more with that. So I wanted to try and do it, but we didn't have time right now. So that's something I'm probably going to try and do in the meantime. And then, I don't know, if we end up playing like a casual game or something. But those are the main ones. You saw Rose as well. I was super happy to get that because Rose is like pretty much the only good like level 4 tuner for quite a while. So I was really happy to pick that up. It's going to make it much easier to get some of these level 8 synchros out. And then, let's see, we're going into the wheel. I got the Tawny pack, so I ended up opening 5 of them. You might want the card out of there. I can't play it. I got Graceful Charity in there. It's a rare in the retro pack, and I can't use it.
Of course you pull it.
Because I already have one. Yeah, so that's going to be a thing to try and trade for at some point, probably. I wouldn't necessarily be against it.
Yeah.
Because it does make things more fun there. I also got a Nimblemon Monger in there as well. That's kind of funny. And then rarities otherwise, I don't think I got any secrets in this one either, but I did get a few more things than before. You've seen all the Ultra stuff I picked up. I got Raijin, which is kind of the bad one out of the two, so I'm not really fussed there. Psychic Trigger was also one I picked up. Like, if your life points are lower than the opponent's, it's a draw card for the psychics. What does this do again? So like, two psychic monsters in your graveyard, remove them from play and draw 2 cards. So if I ever wanted to try and do the Mind Master thing, that's a draw card I could use, though it is a trap, so... and then the only other one I even got as a holo wasn't from this set, it was from the retro pack. I got Catapult Turtle. So that's funny. That pretty much it. I got 2 pieces of Vixodia too. Because of course. And then yeah, the Ghost Red Black Rose. That was pretty much it. There's a lot of stuff I could probably look back in here and go, oh, there's some kind of neat things in here, like Morphtronic, the Accelerator, the destruction card off of that. I think I got 3 copies of that, but I have no idea how I would run that at the moment. I got 1/7 Tools of the Bandit from the retro pack, so I guess that's kind of cool.
That's
like the first trap negation.
Yeah, that's
that
pretty
I
good
have.
One there. That's one I was wanting in early stage.
Yeah, it was an Ultra at the beginning, but and then I got like my playset of Senju, like of the 10 of the 1,000 Hands, so I'm like 1 Manju away from playing Rituals now. That's fun. Second Trap Hole, but I don't think I'm going to need to use like regular Trap Hole at this point. I don't think it's as good as the other options I've got. Maddie the Bug, strongest monster in all of Duel Monsters, got 2 of those. And just trying to think otherwise. I caught another Thunder Dragon, would be do. Another MST, because that's a common. 2 copies, no, 4 copies of Toon World. Let's go back and play Toons now, right? Oh dear. Stupid card is stupid, but yeah. Not a lot else that I'm really that like fussed on now. I don't think. There's a lot of stuff I need to go back and look, like say the plant monsters, I want to see if I can make something out of it.
The plant monsters were looked interesting. I just didn't know how well they would be working with all the other plant monsters. I mean, I guess we have tons of plant monsters at this point. So, I mean, I guess they're possible to use at this point.
I need to go back and look at past sets and see what sort of plants that I could potentially use. Like, that's the main thing. I don't have time to do that right now. So, I mean, not when we're building decks for a stream duel.
I mean, who does? Who does at this point? So, I guess you saw on my end, a retro pack, the Upstart Goblin, the Painful Choice, Mystical Space Typhoon, now I have 4 of those, yay, again. I wanted to try it, and I think it would actually work in this case, Megamorph.
Oh, that's cool.
Megamorph is
pretty
good one. And now I have a second Mania Bug, yay. Been set of time, I had a while. 2 Magic Jammers, so I don't have to use the Cursed Seal to just discard a magic card. I can play Gaia the Champion because I got one Gaia. Guide of Fierce Knight.
Oh, I got Curse of Dragon. That was fun. So I finally have the dragon.
And I,
he's useless.
I mean, he's useless, yeah. Aside from that, I drew my third Thunder Dragon, so now I can play the Thunder Dragons if I wanted to. And a twin-headed Thunder Dragon, so I can even fusion summon him if I really wanted to.
Yo, hype. Yeah, I tried to do that before and failed.
I mean,
so,
but I mean that's just me. One of them. But Fluta Summoning Dragon, I need a Lord of D now. Mm-hmm. Aside from that, retro packs were just meh at that point. Crossroads. Aside from that, with the Crossroads, nothing too spectacular. Then only had four Super Rares out of the pack, so none, no really decent pulls. Just Psychic Trigger, Urgent Tuning, which that probably would have helped. Probably would have helped in that fight. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Knight's End Sorcerer.
Oh, I wanted that one. He's level 2 spellcaster, so I was like, I could apprentice this magician with
you
that.
Could, yes. one day. And then Haniwada. Which, Haniwada, discard this card, take no effect damage. Aside from that...
Hey, that's stuff quick effect.
Aside from that, one card I kind of want to try, Tiger Dragon, if I can get my dragon deck back. Uh-huh.
Yep, I did spot that one. I got a couple of it, I think, and I was like, that's neat. I don't have enough low-level dragons for it at the moment, but it's cool. I think we might get some more as we go through. So, and I think Debris Dragon is in the next set, so that would be kind of neat to run with. So, maybe in the future.
Well, no. The only other card I did show... No, I mentioned it, but Kunai was... No, I did mention that last time. That's the last card I got from last time, Kunai.
Yeah, it's the last set, Kunai, yeah.
Aside from that, not a whole lot of interesting cards. Just... This draw was pretty... not great, I'm gonna admit.
Yeah, I got the bad end of the previous set. You got the bad end of this one, by the looks of it. It happens. Well, regardless, I guess we'll just need to see what next time brings. Although we do have Yusei packs to open, so we might want to do that before we go out of this one so that we can actually have those for, like, deck ideas in between.
Yeah.
You might be able to use your Nitro Warrior if you draw the Synchron out of that, so... Okay, so the champion pack this time, I mean, the Tony pack thing, it is champion pack 7 this time. So you'll get one of those to open. You'll get your choice on the wheel now because, you know, you've had your one force one. The deck is still the starter deck from last time. This is the last year of 2000, the last pack of 2008. So Gold Series promo still 2008. The deck is still Yu-Gi-Oh! 5Ds 2008, like the starter deck one. And Champion Pack 7 is the thing to open.
Champion Pack 7, that's what's open afterwards?
Yeah, you'll get... That's the Tony pack for this
Champion
time.
Pack.
So,
oh, that's the Tony pack.
Yeah, and then we have Duelist Pack Yusei Fudo 1. It's like the 8th Duelist pack or something. We've got 10 packs of that to open before we go to the next set.
So we open that first then, and then I keep forgetting, one pack of the tournament pack for...
Yeah, one of the tournament pack. I'll be opening two because of the win.
Tournament pack 7,
We wanted to make sure it was at least, you know, we're sticking with that whole loser still gets something but not as much type of thing off it, which I think is still making this better. So we have that, and then the wheel if you want to take it. You can decide otherwise, that's totally fine as well. And then, the Yusei packs before we... as we're signing off, I guess, here. So we can open stuff. Might end up playing some games in between, like, by ourselves and whatnot. I think that would be... could be fun as well, but...
We'll decide on that, yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, thank you very much for playing, dude. I guess the wheel from last time is still there if you need that. And, I'll talk to you later on.
GG's.
Yeah, GG's, dude.
Ah, blah. Man, that was such a tough situation. I don't know. There was no way out of that, sadly. I really don't think there was any way out of it. Oh, well. Alright, well, we got our duelist pack, we got our tournament pack, and then we're gonna get the wheel. So let's just see what's in these packs then. If it's anything interesting. Well, Junk Warrior is a level 5 synchro. It's Junk Synchron. Relies on. Well, there's Nitro Synchron. Yay! Now I can use that for Nitro Synchron. And what do you know? Another copy of Nitro Warrior. That's funny. That's funny. Nope. That's interesting there. Another Nitro Warrior. That's 3 Nitro Warriors. Yep, Urgent Tuning. Why, Nitro Warrior? Why? Limiter Overload. What's that? If this card is sent to the graveyard, special summon 1 Speed Warrior from your deck, hand, or graveyard. Speed Warrior, huh? There's a Speed Warrior. Yep. Once per battle phase. Yep. Alright. Slide the draft. Alright, let's choose a set. And we'll just open like 1 tournament pack for now, which he said was tournament pack 7. Did we pass it? Oh, we didn't. Tournament pack 7. It must be a lot different than the last pack we opened. It's a retro pack. Oh, because it was a retro pack. Yeah, okay. Well, Soul Exchange. That's a very interesting card. Yeah, that's not bad. That's really not that bad. Especially if I'm actually doing my Monarch deck. That's one that's going to be very interesting to use. Alright, I still don't have a quantity of any cards above rare, sadly. So I guess I'm just going to have to spin the wheel. And 3 more tournament packs. Well, you know it. Well, if we got something like Soul Exchange out of it, this will be an interesting pack regardless. Right? Super Rare Fortress Whale. Sure. Wall of Illusion's not bad, though. Bust up later. I mean, Fortress Whale is interesting, but that's a super rare. I don't know. It's worth $479. How? Oh, bad collection? Alright. This one. This is 2. And this is 3. Last Will and Testament. Well, get on with it. The bar is open soon. The monster in your starter field was sent to your graveyard this turn. You can special summon 1 monster with a tank 1500 points or less from your deck once during this turn. Then shuffle your deck. Oh. Oh, that's interesting. Well, that's not a bad draw, I guess. That's definitely an interesting one for sure. Alright, as for my trade-in, yeah, again, nothing above rare, so... I guess I should probably get Iron Chain Dragon just to have another Synchro Summon as an option. I think I'll do that, actually. Got four Mozyaks, so I'll trade one of him for Iron Chain Dragon. There we go. Alright, well, that's it for today. Yeah, that was, I'm not gonna lie, that's a bit of a bummer, but I mean, that happens. That happens. I'm gonna stretch and probably get ready to do some workout in a minute. Work outside, I should say. In the meantime, though, I'll call it a day at that. So, thanks everybody for watching. Thanks everyone for sticking around. Yeah, three Quillbots. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be using those, but we'll see what happens. Not the greatest start to card games on motorcycles, but, I mean, that's not the worst thing to happen. I mean, I've lost in worse ways than that, I guess. In the meantime, though, yeah, I'll be calling it a day there. So, thanks for everybody who's come by, sticking around. If you like what you watch, make sure you follow and do that, whatever. And stick around for next time, because I think Monday we'll try and open two more packs that way. Maybe Sunday, actually, because Sunday I will know I have some time to myself, because I will be having half house to myself and got all that, so that'll be good. In the meantime, though, yeah, that's going to be it. So, thanks, and yeah, take care, folks. Bye-bye.